Throughout this tutorial, we'll be applying the concepts of neuronal structure to a specific kind of behavior, one that you've probably all experienced, which is pain sensation. Here, in part one, if I touch a hot pot, I initially don't feel the pain, but I have a very quick withdrawal reflex to move my hand away from the source of pain. Finally, I feel the pain and deploy other behaviors that I've learned over the years to mitigate the pain. We'll come back throughout the tutorial to this experience and think about what different neurons are involved and what they look like. In this tutorial, you'll learn about what aspects of neurons are critical to their function, how they are just like. In the rest of this video, you'll learn about what aspects of neurons are critical to their function, how they are just like other cells, and how they are special, what functions they have that allow them to sense information and integrate multiple sources of information and transmit that information to other parts of the nervous system quickly, which is their primary function. Let's start with a generalized animal cell. Neurons are just a specialized form of this, just like this cell here. They have a nucleus containing a lot of the genetic information required to make all the proteins of the cell. They are surrounded by a cell membrane, which is critical for separating inside from outside compartments. In another tutorial, we'll see that's really important for transmitting electrical signals. I won't go through all the internal compartments besides the nucleus that I already mentioned, but they are also all present in neurons. For example, mitochondria play a critical role since so many neuronal functions require a lot of energy. Because neurons have this important function of communicating between parts of the body that can be very far apart, they have an extended shape, which we'll discuss in much more detail. Here you can see in this diagram the extent of many different neurons in the nervous system, both the peripheral and central nervous systems, which you've heard about in other tutorials. Globally, we can think about three different types of neurons: sensory neurons, which bring in information from the outside, motor neurons, which control muscles, and then everything else is an interneuron. They communicate between other neurons of the nervous system. Now let's apply this to the behavior that we were talking about, pain sensation. Sensory neurons at the periphery of the nervous system have to detect the heat from the hot pot. That single neuron can be over a meter in length, depending on how long your arm is. They have to transmit that information to the nervous system in order for the nervous system to react. Part of that reaction involves motor neurons, which communicate to muscles in the arm to withdraw the hand from the source of the pain. In addition, there are interneurons coordinating the communication between sensory and motor neurons, as well as transmitting that information up into the brain so that the physical sensation of pain can be received. Neurons come in many amazing shapes and sizes, depending on their function and location in the nervous system. We'll discuss four general features that apply to all neurons. Dendrites, which are best seen here as small protrusions from the cell body. Some neurons have very few and others have many. All neurons have a cell body, and all neurons have an axon, which can be highly branched or not very branched. And these axons terminate in synapses. Those allow for communication with other cells. Let's start with the dendrites. Dendrites bring in information into the neuron. They are responsible for detecting it and transmitting that information to the rest of the cell. Dendritic trees can be quite extensive, as demonstrated here by these two different types of cells found in the brain. These networks of dendrites allow multiple different stimuli to be detected by a single neuron. The dendrites can be receiving external stimuli. So if you remember from the pain behavior, the sensory neuron is receiving hot temperature information from the external environment. Dendrites can also receive stimuli from other neurons in the form of neurotransmitter. This is the case for the motor neuron, which will exert the response to that pain information. In both cases, these different types of information are received through specialized proteins localized to the dendrites. The cell body of the neuron is what's most equivalent to all other cells in the body. It contains the nucleus, the genetic information, and it also is where the majority of proteins that are required for the function of the neuron are made through transcription and translation. The cell body also plays an important role in integrating information that's coming in from the different dendrites. The cell body, in effect, serves as a gatekeeper to determine whether information gets passed down into the next part of the cell, the axon. The part of the neuron that we often pay the most attention to is the axon. It is where information is transmitted away from the body, the cell body, towards the next cell in the communications chain. In this brain section, we have an example of a motor cortex neuron in which the cell body would be found here in the motor cortex part of the central nervous system where decisions are made about whether to move something or not. In our pain scenario, this neuron might be involved in the conscious movement of the hand toward the pot initially, but not in the reflexive movement to withdraw the hand. This neuron has a set of dendrites from which it's going to receive information, and then a very extensive set of axonal projections to communicate to other cells within the brain. The axon is specialized for the quick movement of information via electrical impulses, and we'll discuss what that looks like in another tutorial. You may have noticed these little bumps along the axon here. These denote myelinating cells. In certain parts of the mammalian nervous system, specialized glial cells wrap themselves around parts of the axons and help to speed the conduction of electrical impulses down the axon. Not all neurons are myelinated, even within the human body. Some are unmyelinated, and that means that they transmit information less quickly. Finally, as the electrical impulse flows to the end of the neuron farthest away from the cell body, it will reach the synapse. There, it must be converted into a chemical signal in the form of neurotransmitter so that it can pass through this gap between two cells that form the synapse. The presynaptic cell receives the information and releases packets of neurotransmitters that will be sensed by the dendrites of the postsynaptic cells. There are different types of cells that can exist past the synapse. Often they are other neurons, so interneurons such as the neuron of the motor cortex that's going to decide how your muscle moves. It communicates exclusively to other neurons. But the motor neuron that exists in the spinal cord and is going to communicate directly to the musculature, it forms specialized synapses onto muscle fibers. In addition, our nervous system can control the release of hormones through gland cells. And so some neurons that are part of the endocrine system make synapses onto gland cells and control the release of hormone, which can influence cells over even longer distances. In this tutorial, you've learned about the different parts of neurons: the dendrites that receive information, the cell body that integrates that information, the axon that transmits that information, and the synapse that communicates to other cells.